Today I'm replacing mid-range units in Mission 782 speakers because I'm suffering Mission mid-range unit failure in both of my speakers. Mid-range unit failure in Missions was quite a common problem across the 78 series of speakers. You might ask how to tell if my Mission mid-range has failed, because on the 782s at least, they still sound quite good, even with a failed mid-range. Well, actually, it's fairly easy. Put some music on that has a reasonable range in it and simply listen at the treble and mid-range units. And quite simply, you'll be able to hear that it's not working. Of course, simply hearing that this unit isn't working doesn't tell me that it's the unit that's failed. At this point, it could also be the crossover. Having said that, if you've got Mission 782s and you can't hear anything coming out of there, it's highly likely to be the mid-range unit itself, not the crossover. Of course, if you've got Mission 780s, which are bookshelf speakers, you'll be able to tell straight away that because there'll be a complete lack of bass end of the music. How to get the mid-range units out and replace them. First thing, very important, turn your amplifier off and disconnect the speakers at the terminals at the back. Remove the front grille. You will need a posy number 2. That's a PZ2 screwdriver, not a Phillips. Hook the little rubber bungs out of the front of the speaker. And then with your posy number 2, engage in the screw, nice and square, and undo. Once you've removed those four screws, again with your screwdriver, in one of the holes, just twist it slightly sideways, get the plastic cover started, lift it away squarely but gently. Be careful because the tweeter is mounted within this plastic casing. So let it hang, and again with your posy number 2, take out the four screws that hold the mid-range in, or the base unit in if you're working on a pair of 780s. All 8 screws that hold the plastic cover in and the speaker in are all the same, so don't worry about mixing them up. Just drop them into a little glass or bowl to keep them safe. As you withdraw this unit, be careful of the gasket. Unless you're getting a new gasket with the new units that you've obtained, you will need to use it again. Be careful too not to strain the wires. There isn't much in the way of excess length on these wires. Now you might need a pair of pliers at this point, but the wires are connected to the speaker with spades, which you should be able to waggle off gently and remove the unit, and then recover the gasket. The way I confirmed that it was the mid-range units and not the crossover was I used a car speaker, which I happened to have in the garage, simply connected it to the spades with a little music running, and of course as soon as I did so, the car speaker sprung into life and was playing the music, which tells me that it was not the crossover but was in fact the units. Now you might be asking, where can I get spare Mission mid-range units? I got my spare units off a seller on eBay. Mission did eventually change supplier on these units and made a Mark II version, but I'm afraid I don't know whether they still do. If you're looking second hand though, I'll put a list of the speakers that had the same unit in it down in the description so you can refer to it. In the top of the cabinet just here, behind where the top corners of the plastic fascia go, there are two little pads which are clearly there for anti-rattle purposes. They're not stuck in, so be careful not to lose them. It's then just a simple matter of putting it back together the way it came apart. And of course you can check it using the same method that you did before. And you should be able to hear the difference straight away. The music you're hearing in this video, by the way, is from my good friends the Black Strat Band from their album Absence, and it is track 4, Lost in the Sea, in memory of Alan Curdy. He was that young boy who was pulled out of the sea, and the pictures of him being lifted out of the sea dead, having drowned, went all around the world. You can see the video to this track on YouTube. I'll put a link in the description. If you got value out of this video, consider supporting the channel, and I shall see you next time.